this video, I'm gonna be talking about one of the most exciting experiences in physics, especially in quantum physics. But first, what is quantum physics? In the 19th century, scientists observed that atomic and subatomic particles didn't act the same as novel objects. They didn't submit to the physical rules that scientists put on the basis of their observations, which had been spread over the years. This is why theories had been made to describe the nature of the smallest scalar of energy. The wave particle duality is one of the strangest stories in quantum physics, so let me tell you about it. This is the story of the mysterious aspects of light. It all started in the early 1800s when Thomas Young tried to solve this mysterious problem.
He allowed light to pass through a slit in a barrier, so it expanded out in wavefronts from the slit as light source. That light, in turn, passed through the pair of slits in another barrier. Each slit, in turn, diffracted light as if they were also individual sources of light. The light impacted an observation screen
in dark, and this experiment proved that light traveled in waves. Then, in 1965, Maxwell demonstrated that light was electromagnetic waves with a way that convinced everyone and seemed totally logical. So the problem was solved. But then, in 1905, Einstein demonstrated with a very logical way to him that convinced everyone that light was a photon. But how is that even possible? How can we combine these two completely contradictory aspects? Is light a wave or a particle? Shortly after, we put a conclusion, and that just for light, every quantum object is at once corpuscle, like a tennis ball, and wave, like a wave in the sea. A bit like a tennis ball that would be in many places at once. It was possible in the modern world to realize Young's experience, this time with electrons, by launching them one by one.
The source is an electron gun. If we open a single slit, a single band appears. These first experiments support the hypothesis that electrons are particles. Now let's open both slits. What would be logical is to see two bands appearing, but that's not the case. Bands of light and dark appears, as the light did in Young's experience. But how can electrons act like particles when there is only one slit, and like waves when there is two slits? So scientists put a measuring device right next to the two slits to try to understand what's going on. But the quantum world is a lot more mysterious. The electron began to behave like particles. Two bands appeared. The electron acted differently, as if they were aware that they were being watched.
Maybe the things we see are this way only when we look at them. In reality, particles are everywhere at the same time. When we look at them, they start to act normally. And as Bohr said, who is not shocked by quantum theory does not understand it.